हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर अमित बागड़े। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अवर फोर्थ एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट यूनिट ऑफ अवर इंजीनियरिंग फिजिक्स सिलेबस, विच इज नेम्ड एज क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर एंड एक्सरे डिफ्रैक्शन। द कोर्स आउटकम ऑफ दिस यूनिट इज दैट एट द एंड ऑफ द कोर्स स्टूडेंट और यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्रिस्टलोग्राफी। इन दिस चैप्टर we are discussed about the introduction of some introduction about crystallography, that is crystal structure. In this unit we also study the unit cell, seven crystal systems, Miller indices, then Brevais space lattices, Bragg's law, X-ray diffraction and Moseley's law, and finally the relation between lattice constant and density of unit cell. So these are the points which is included in the crystal structure and X-ray diffraction unit. Okay, now let us discuss about the some basic introduction about the crystal structure and X-ray diffraction. So this crystal structure and X-ray diffraction is also known as the crystallography. Okay, so the element, as we know, the elements and their chemical compounds are found to be occur in a three stable state, that is first is solid state, second is a liquid state, and third one is the gaseous state. Solid having definite shape, definite volume, liquid having no definite shape but possesses definite volume, gases having no definite shape and no definite volume. Okay, so the crystallography or the crystal structure and X-ray diffraction is related to only solid state materials only. So the crystallography, now the first question is that what is mean by the crystallography. Okay, so crystallography is the combination of two words, that is crystal and graphene. So crystal, it has its usual meaning, like the sugar particle, so this is the crystal. And graphene is the means to write. Okay, so the crystallography means the writing about the crystal is known as the crystallography. Okay, and the crystallography is the branch of physics which deals with to study the physical properties of crystalline material or physical properties of crystalline solid. As far as considered the crystal structure, the solids are divided into two types, that is crystalline solid and amorphous solid. In crystalline solid, the atoms or molecules are arranged in a regular fashion, then it is known as crystalline solid. And in amorphous solid, the atoms or molecules are arranged in an irregular fashion, then the such a solids are known as amorphous solid. Okay, so before starting this unit, we should know about the some basic concepts of crystallography, that is the space lattice and basis. So this is a very basic concept, space lattice and basis. Okay, space lattice, it is also, for question is what is mean by space lattice. Okay, suppose this is the space which is given in a crystal. Okay, so the space lattice, it is the regular three-dimensional periodic arrangement of atoms or molecule in a space. Okay, so this is known as the space lattice. Suppose these are the atoms or molecule which is situated in the given crystal. Okay, so it is the regular three-dimensional periodic arrangement of points in a given space is known as space lattice. So this figure shows, or figure A shows, the one-dimensional space lattice which showing how the particles are arranged regularly along x-axis. This figure shows the two-dimensional space lattice which shows how the particles are arranged in a x-plane and y-plane, or x-axis and y-axis. So the distance between two successive points in x-axis is a which is constant, and distance along y-axis, or distance along two successive points, between two successive points along y-axis is b. And this figure shows the three-dimensional space lattice which showing how the particles are arranged in a x, y and z plane. Suppose this is the x, suppose this is the y plane, and this is the z axis. Okay, so this shows how the particles are situated or arranged in a x, y and z axis. Okay, so this is a three-dimensional, this is a two-dimensional, this is the one-dimensional space lattice. Our next point is a basis. Okay, whenever a single atom, suppose this is the external atom, whenever a single atom or a group of atom is attached with every lattice point in a space lattice, then such a arrangement is called as basis. Okay, whenever a single atom or a group of external atom is attached with every lattice point in a space lattice, then such arrangement is called as basis. So the space lattice and basis gives the complete crystal structure. In this figure, we seen that the external atom or a group of atom is attached with every lattice point in a space lattice. So this figure shows the, so this is the basis. Okay, so the space lattice and basis gives the complete crystal structure. Now let us start the first point of our syllabus, that is the unit cell. So question is the, what is mean by unit cell? Okay, so unit cell is the smallest geometrical block or figure in a space lattice. Suppose these are the space lattice. Okay, see, these are the space lattice or regular three-dimensional periodic arrangement of the atoms or molecule. Okay, so in this space lattice, the smallest geometrical block or figure in a space lattice is the unit cell. Okay, so this is the simple cubic unit cell. This is the tetragonal, this is the hexagonal. Okay, like that. So this smallest geometrical block or figure in a space lattice is known as unit cell. Okay, so the unit cell is divided into two types. First is a primitive unit cell and second is a non-primitive unit cell. So in case of primitive unit cell, all the atoms or molecules are situated at the corner of the unit cells. Okay, or the atoms or molecule are present at the corner of the unit cell only, then such a unit cell is known as primitive unit cell. In case of non-primitive unit cell, all the atoms or molecule are present at the corner of the unit cell as well as the center of the unit cell and at the faces of the unit cell. So such unit cells are known as non-primitive unit cell. So this unit cell is also known as simple cubic unit cell. This unit cell is known as body-centered cubic unit cell, and this is the face-centered cubic unit cell. Okay, so in these three unit cells, we seen that the six atoms present at the faces of the unit cell as well as the corners of the unit cell. And this figure shows the atoms present at the corner of the unit cell as well as the one atom is present at the center of the unit cell or center body center of the unit cell. So this is the BCC, this is the FCC, and this is the simple cubic. So simple cubic unit cell is represented as the symbol P. This is the body-centered unit cell. This is the denoted as symbol I, and this is the denoted as the symbol F. Okay. So this is the unit cell. This is the smallest geometrical block or figure in a space lattice is known as unit cell. Now our next point is Brauweis space lattice. So in 1848, Brauweis is the name of scientist. Okay. So in 1848, Brauweis suggested that there are only 14 ways of arranging the atoms or molecule in a space lattice. Okay, there are total 14 ways of arranging the atoms or molecule in a space lattice. Then these 14 ways are known as Brauweis space lattice. That is, there are total 14 type of sub lattices or 14 types of unit cell. So these 14 types of unit cells are known as Brauweis space lattices. For example, suppose cubic system. So cubic system having three sub lattices or three Brauweis lattices, that is simple cubic, body center cubic, and face center cubic. Okay, so this is suppose the unit cell and this is the cubic unit cell. So cubic unit cell having three sub lattices, simple cubic, body center cubic, face center cubic. Okay, we also know that there are total seven crystal systems, and that is cubic, tetragonal, hexagonal, trigonal, orthorhombic, monoclinic, and triclinic. So these are the seven crystal systems. Okay, and seven crystal system, for example cubic system, there are three sub lattices, that is simple cubic, body centered cubic, and face centered cubic. Tetragonal having two sub lattices, simple tetragonal and body centered tetragonal. Hexagonal having one sub lattices, that is simple hexagonal, simple trigonal. Orthorhombic system having four sub lattices, that is PIFC, that is simple orthorhombic, body center orthorhombic, and face centered orthorhombic. And C is the base centered orthorhombic. Okay, base centered. So atoms present at the corner of the unit cell and two atoms are present at the upper and lower faces of the unit cell. This is the base centered unit cell. Okay, And last is a monoclinic and triclinic. Monoclinic having two sublattices, that is simple monoclinic and base center monoclinic. And last one is a triclinic. Triclinic having only one sublattices, that is simple triclinic. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So these 14 type of unit cells are 14 ways are known as Brewy's space lattices. Okay, so friends, the first lecture is over. Now in second lecture we will discuss about the properties of unit cell, that is coordination number, number of atoms per unit cell, atomic radius, and packing density. Thank you.